Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near, you may hear angels cheer, 'cause we're together. Weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. Just say the words and we'll beat the birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's perfect for a flying honeymoon, they say. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near, you may hear angels cheer, 'cause we're together. Weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. You just say the words and we'll beat the birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's perfect for a flying honeymoon, they say. Come fly with me, let's fly, let's fly. Pack up, let's fly away.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They're like much more than I never knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Welcome. Today we are gathered together for a very special and joyous occasion, and that is to witness and bless the joining of Michael and Sarah in marriage. Marriage is a beautiful relationship between two people, and it's a union founded on love. Michael, if I can please ask you to take your bride's bouquet and just carefully place it on the rock, and then I'll have the two of you join both of each other's hands. And I asked you to join hands as a symbol of the union that you're making here today. And I want you to think about the hands that you're holding, because these are the hands of your very best friend holding your hands on your wedding day, promising to love you and work with you as you build your future together. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need strength, tenderness when you need tenderness, and love when you need love. These are the hands that will also hold all of whom you love. And these are the hands that through your lifetime together will wipe tears of sorrow from your eyes, but hopefully many, many more tears of joy. And these are the hands that years from now will still be searching for your hands, still seeking the love, encouragement, and support that each of you will give to one another. And all of these things have brought you all the way here today to the beautiful Grand Canyon. And now, on this very special day, I'd like to read a poem that was written by Michael to celebrate the special bond that brought the two of them together. When love is right and kind, it comes as a swift wind that steals your breath and takes you afar, to where the heart feels and the mind knows things it has never before. To look and see you smile, your gleaming eyes brings a singular light to my life, my soul. All else fades as the certainty of you gives me all I will ever need. And now you are both here today for the purpose of saying your marriage vows to one another. And it's important to understand that these vows cannot be made lightly, and I'm sure the two of you realize this. These vows need to be made with a great deal of consideration and respect. With that thought in mind, Michael, I have a question for you. Do you take Sarah to be your wife, to live together in marriage, to love her, comfort her, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful only to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Then please repeat this vow after me. Sarah, you bring sun to my days.
Sarah,
the brightest stars to my nights. You are the center of everything. I will be there to share your joys, to help shoulder your burdens, to be your partner in all things. May the comfort of my arms always feel like home. May our family be your greatest source of happiness. I promise to keep you first in my heart, first in my thoughts, first in my deeds. I, Michael, choose you, Sarah, to be my wife, to love you, to honor you, to cherish you, to stand by you for all of my days. Sarah, are you ready to say your marriage vows to Michael?
Yes.
Then I also have a question for you as well. Do you take Michael to be your husband, to live together in marriage, to love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful only to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Then please repeat after me. Michael, you bring sun to my days.
Michael, you bring sun to my days.
The brightest stars to my nights.
The brightest stars to my nights.
You are the center of my everything. I will be there to share your joys, to help shoulder your burdens, to be your partner in all things. May the comfort of my arms always feel like home. May our family be your greatest source of happiness. I promise to keep you first in my heart, first in my thoughts, first in my deeds. I, Sarah, choose you, Michael, to be my husband. To love you, to honor you, to cherish you, to stand by you for all of my days. Perfect. And now, Michael and Sarah, if you can just carefully hold one another's wedding ring for a moment, and we'll talk about the wedding rings. And throughout time, the wedding ring has been a symbol of unending love, because like time, your rings have no beginning and no end. They're the emblem of eternity. They're also made of metals that are least likely to tarnish. And these things symbolize the pledges that you just finished making to one another here this afternoon. But above all else, your wedding rings will now be an outward and visible sign signifying to all the uniting of this man and this woman in marriage. Michael, please place Sarah's ring on her finger. Hold it there and repeat after me. Sarah, this ring serves as an outward symbol of my unending and unbreakable love for you. Wear it in celebration of the happiness we have created. And trust that I will be by your side and on your side forever. As I place it on your finger, our life as a family begins. Throughout your life, let it be a proud reminder of our love and commitment on this day and always. Perfect. You can slide it all the way on.
It's on.
Okay, I couldn't see. Yep. Sarah, place Michael's ring on his finger, please, and repeat after me. Michael, this ring serves as an outward symbol of my unending and unbreakable love for you. Wear it in celebration of the happiness we have created. And trust that I will be by your side and on your side forever. As I place it on your finger, our life as a family begins. Throughout your life, let it be a proud reminder of our love and commitment on this day and always. Perfect. It looks like you have it all the way on. Michael, I'll have you give your bride her bouquet back, and then I'll have the two of you face me the way we started. Michael and Sarah, in just a minute, I'm going to pronounce you husband and wife. Before I do that, I'd like to say a couple very brief things about marriage. They may be brief, but they're good things to keep in mind. Marriage is being in love for the rest of your life. It's love walking hand in hand with your very best friend. It's thinking of new things to do together. It's laughing about the silly things in life with care and tenderness. It's trusting each other, even though from time to time the two of you may be very far apart. It's the realization there's no one else in the world you'd rather be with, certainly no one else you'd rather be married to. It's growing old together, but most of all, marriage is being in love for the rest of your life. Michael and Sarah, you've made your marriage vows to one another, witnessed by those of us here today. You've sealed those vows with the giving and the receiving of the wedding rings. So now it's my very great honor to pronounce you husband and wife. And Michael, you may kiss your bride. And it gives me great pleasure to introduce, when they come up for air for the very first time, as a married couple, Mr. and Mrs. Michael and Sarah Reardon. Congratulations. And now, Sarah and Michael, I believe you would like to say a few words to your friends and family.
Yes, I hope you can hear us. We love you and can't thank you enough for all of the support and encouragement you've given us, and for being okay with us coming out to the Grand Canyon. For this marriage. It is absolutely beautiful here, and we know you're here in spirit, and we can't wait to show you the video and the pictures and have you with us as we spend the rest of our life together.
We love you all.
Thank you.
All right, how about one more big kiss?
Ooh.
true. Ooh, someday you wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind. Be where trouble melts like lemon drops, high above the chimney top, that's where you find me. Oh, somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly, and the dream that you dare to, oh why can't I, oh, someday I wish upon a star, wake up where the clouds are far behind. Be where trouble melts like a lemon drops, high above the chimney top, that's where you find me. Oh, somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, and the dream that you dare to, why, oh why can't I.